Okay, so if we talk about lower back, that could come from many things. Human can have kissing spine just as much as horses can have kissing spine, which means overriding dorsal processes, right? And that, of course, no saddle can help. But what can happen is, and I heard this many riders say, when I don't ride, I have back pain. When I ride, I don't have back pain. So if we, let's say, it's not as severe, and Marie does not have kissing spine, it's not fused, then I would go and says, okay, what do the experts say? And when I say expert, of course, I go not to an Olympic rider or to somebody who sells a lot of saddle. I go to a medical doctor who studied and lived with different types of skeletons. So they ask me to come up with a way to butt cast a rider's seat position. And when I say rider seat position, look at these people. Nobody would sit on the toilet like this or on the dinner table like this. A riding seat is like a standing seat, which means your pelvis and spine is aligned. The only difference is there's no weight on your feet. The weight is on your seat bone. Male or female, okay? So once we did all these cast difference, what we came up with is says, oh wow, there's a huge difference between the male and the female seat. And then they say, well, he showed me how the male pelvis sits on the horse. So he put the male pelvis on the horse and he says, because the pelvis axis of the male is in the center and the guy has lower curvature in the back muscle and longer tailbone, his butt cheek, like his gluteus maximus, are closer to the horse, and the front bone on the pelvis, the pubic symphysis, is high. So because the pivoting point of the pelvis is in the center, and you got your butt cheek here, easy for beginner male riders to learn how to ride. Easy. If you are a lady, you have it harder to learn to ride because your pivot point is in the front. So your hip socket is more in front of your pelvis, it's not in the center. So your tendency is to fall back. You also have more lordosis than the average male. And as I said earlier, there are four different type of pelvises, and some pelvis are even more so than other, but in general, the pelvis is more tilt forward. That means the front bone, the front part of your pelvis, of course, the pubic symphysis, it's lower to the horse's withers. So furthermore, because of your curvature in the lower back, your gluteus maximus sits higher. So with the shorter tailbone, and that doesn't matter which of the four female pelvis you have, all four different female pelvises have a shorter tailbone because that allows room for the baby's head to come through it. So that means you have less support underneath the butt cheek like a guy. So that explains every time I went to riding school and I saw a husband and wife or boyfriend and girlfriend start to ride, he just comes along because he likes her, but instantly the guy has the seat and the girls always try so hard. Bareback in the saddle doesn't matter. It's to get what we call a riding seat. It is not on the feet, the weight, but on your pelvis. And then, of course, there's many other features, but that really struck me. And he showed me a couple of pictures like this, the shorter tailbone I just talked about versus the male. The male can have a crotch or fork seat, which means the femur can hang straight down. It cannot because of the hip socket on the lady. Okay. So how can I afford to say what can I recommend to have less pain? So number one, you should not sit in the saddle what doesn't support you in the back, because you will fall down and you will tighten your back so tight to hold yourself in balance. And the reason that is, this is the pelvis axis. You can see here on the male is in the center, on the female in the front. Gravity rules, you fall back. So without support, these type of riders, very often riders in the male saddles, no matter how strong you are, you can only squish your thigh and your hips so much. Okay, so when that happens, then it's a very slow process, but it's happening. You cannot avoid it. Your disc will slip. And a slipped disc goes into the nerves, and a collapsed disc, you need an operation. So that is super painful. So before you go into these two stages, your back muscle goes super tight. So when your back muscle gets tight, well, then of course you have more and more tension. Good riders have a six pack in the front of the stomach. They have strong, strong riders because they absorb the sitting trot in the stomach muscle. Riders with back pain have most of the time the back muscle more active to support themselves rather than the obliques. And very often comes because if the saddle is too wide in the waist before your hip hurts, you don't even realize because inside your leg runs the sciatic nerve. And when that saddle is too wide in the pelvis, okay, you might have enough support in the seat, but you might have a saddle what is too wide between your upper inner thigh. Then what will happen? That your sciatic nerve pinches and that goes right to your back. And before you even know, you say, oh, that hurts. So you either release the pain by bringing your legs forward or sit here to make the back round. But now everybody who sees this picture knows when that horse spooks, the rider falls off instantly. Often I see riders shifting from one side to the other to relieve the pain on the right hip or the left hip. And then we create a whole new problem. We make the saddle crooked because the rider doesn't have the right twist. And that is kind of what is so important that people really understand. This very often comes from clinicians who speak. Too many riders hang in the mouth and a cramped seat. Okay, that causes, as I said, the tension in the back because I don't use the obliques. My recommendation, really try to use the saddle where you feel like after riding 20 minutes, you just done your biggest ab workout in your life. So what actually happened, it relaxes your hip, supports your back part of your pelvis so you can relax and let your leg hang underneath you. Now the sitting trough, you absorb in your obliques and you will have a new pain, which causes muscle pain in the stomach. But once the lactic acid disappears, your back pain disappears because you're supporting your whole trunk now with your front muscles, not the back muscles. That is a very common pattern. What we see when riders who have very little space here, typical women, ride in a saddle, but is made for male riders who have more space here. So that is what I recommend to avoid that type of riding.